Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, dear kids. How are you doing? I hope you're doing well and are in the best state of health and iman, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you health and happiness and keep you smiling like the flowers. And may you be a beacon of light and an ideal Muslim. Ameen. Today, inshallah, I will tell you the story of Hazrat Tufail bin Umar ad-Dawsi razi ta'ala anhu. I'm confident after listening to this story, you will wish to be like him. Someone who is high on Iman, and most of all, be of those with whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy. Imagine you are a person who has Allah's pleasure. How lucky is that, isn't it? We will also talk about the dream Allah showed Hazrat Tufail bin Umar ad-Dawsi razi ta'ala anhu. It was a prophecy, which means that the dream came true. Allah also showed him signs which led to be true. How lucky is that? Hazrat Tufail bin Umar lived in the time of ignorance and belonged to the tribe of Dawes and was an eminent leader from the tribe of Dawes only. He was very well respected, rich, brave, and very, very generous. His house was always open to guests. There was never a time when something was not cooking on his stove or he was not hosting guests. He would help the needy, look after the underprivileged. Hazrat Tufail was an extremely talented poet and very, very sharp and intelligent. One day he left his house and headed for Makkah. It is said that these were the days when the Prophet ﷺ had declared his prophethood and was calling people to Islam. The Quraysh were after his blood and he ﷺ was facing severe persecution. Now this story begins from the time that Hazrat Tufail visited Makkah, and let's see what happened. Hazrat Tufail says that when he entered Makkah, all the leaders of Quraysh surrounded him. They were being kind, were generous, were being courteous and very, very cordial. Then they started talking ill about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. Obviously, Hazrat Tufail had no idea who he was, but they started referring to him as one of their people who had lost his mind. Nauzubillah. Then they started talking ill about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, saying evil, derogatory, mean and untrue things about him sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. Things like that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam had made a false claim to prophethood, trying to cause dissension between the people, and that he was breaking houses and separating families, breaking ties of friendship and kinship. So do not even go near him. Be careful. So this problem does not befall you as well. Do not listen to him because he talks magic and ensnares people in his talks. And you know what happens, they said? They say they basically meant that fathers leave their sons and wives their husbands. Anyone who listens and accepts the religion tends to leave their family. Hazrat Tufail says that upon hearing all this, he got very apprehensive and finally decided to stay away from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. Next morning, as per plan, he razi ta'ala anhu went to the Kaaba to pay his tributes to the idols. To be on the safe side, he put cotton buds in his ears to ensure that the magical words do not enter or affect him. Upon entering the Kaaba, he saw Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam offering his salat. His way of praying appealed to his heart. He stood there and observed him, slowly took out the cotton from his ears and went close. As he heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recite the surahs, the happier he felt, the more relaxed he got, the more entranced he felt, and followed the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam home. Upon reaching there, he said, "Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, your people said a lot of negative things about you, but now I like what I heard from you. Please tell me your Lord's message." Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited Surah Ikhlas and Surah Falak. Hazrat Tufail bin Umar says, I was enthralled, and being a poet, I could appreciate the verses being read out. The wordings, the meanings, they touched his heart, and upon saying the kalima, became a Muslim on the spot, alhamdulillah. Firm on that, there is no God but Allah, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last apostle. He left the house of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then he learned the Quran from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, memorized few surahs. A few days later, he went to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, "I am returning to my tribe. They listen to me, but you please pray that my nation also listens to me. Please give me some sign, something, so my people accept the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "O Allah, give Hazrat Tufail bin Amr ad-Dawsi a sign." So when he reached close to his area, he felt a light shine on his forehead. He prayed to Allah that this light should shine somewhere else. The light moved to his spear. It seemed as if he was carrying a candle or a lamp lit on the spear. The first person he met upon returning was his father. The father rushed to embrace him, but he said, "Wait, father, do not come near me, because we do not have a relationship between us, because now I am a Muslim." The father said, "I also submit to the same Lord as you and accept Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the last messenger. Now we are like each other." Next came his wife, and he said the same to her, that "Do not come near me, because there is no relationship between us. I am a Muslim now." The wife said, "How is that possible? May my parents be sacrificed upon you. But why, my dear husband, why?" He said, "Because now I am a Muslim." She said, "Okay, I am a Muslim too. I don't know how, but make me one. I want to be just like you." So I told her, "Go wash yourself. Go wash from the water kept around the idol of Dushara." She said, "Are you not scared of the idol Dushara?" I said, "May death be upon the idol, which is dumb and deaf and just stone. It can do nothing good or bad for us. Go and shower." When she got back, she said the kalima and became a Muslim too. After this, I called my tribe to Islam. But apart from Abu Huraira, no one accepted the message of Allah. So I went back to Makkah with Hazrat Abu Huraira Zitala Anho and went to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, "My tribe is not accepting the message and being very stubborn. Please pray for them." He sallallahu alaihi wasallam raised his hands to the sky and prayed for the tribe of Daws. And he again raised his hands to the sky and prayed for the tribe of Daws. Raised his hands again and prayed for the tribe of Daws. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam then turned to me and said, "You please talk to your people softly and gently and ask them to come to Allah. Be gentle." This is a huge lesson for us, dear kids, that if we want to call people to Allah, we need to be gentle. So then my entire tribe, Hazrat Tufail says, accepted Islam. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam found out, he was very happy. During this time, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated to Medina. So I took 80 households and went to Medina to see the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam was super happy to see my people and gave them a share from the war booty of Khaybar. The war of Khaybar had recently taken place. Then I stayed with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam till the conquest of Makkah. After the destruction of the idols kept in the Kaaba, Tufail radhiyallahu anhu asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to send him to put an end to the worship of Dhulqafain, the chief idol of his people. The Prophet gave him permission. Back in Tehama, among the Daws, men and women and children of the tribe had gathered and were agitated that the idol was going to be burned. They were waiting to see if any evil would befall Tufail radhiyallahu anhu. Tufail radhiyallahu anhu approached the idols with the worshippers around it. As he set fire to it, he proclaimed, "O Dhulqafain, Of your worshippers, I certainly am not. Fire have I inserted into your heart. Whatever Shik remained in the Dawes tribe went up in the flames that burned the idol. The whole tribe became a Muslim. Subhanallah. So Fazl Anhu remained a lieutenant of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam until the noble messenger passed away. So Fazl Anhu then placed himself in the service of the Khalifa Abu Bakr, the successor of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He, along with his son, pledged allegiance to Hazrat Abu Bakr Rizitala Anhu. He, along with his son, Hazrat Umar bin Tufail Rizitala Anhu, remained loyal to the Caliph. During the Ridda Wars, he led a contingent of his people against the impostor Musalima. During this journey, he saw a dream in which his head had been shaved. A bird came out from his mouth. Then he was entered back into the womb of a woman. Tufail's son was in the dream. They were trying to reach to each other, but were unable to. Hizritala Anho shared his dream with his companions, and none could come up with a suitable answer. Then he, Rizitala, himself gave an interpretation of the dream. According to Hazrat Tufail Rizitala Anho, his shaved head meant that he received a fatal wound. Bird being released from his mouth meant his soul was leaving. Entering the womb meant he would enter the grave. Being unable to reach his son meant that his son would also be injured in a battle, but would recover. So this was the interpretation of the dream. But one thing which he was also sure was that the son was equally brave and loyal like him. And he also would die like a martyr and would continue to serve and fight with the Muslims until his last blood. In the Battle of Al-Yamama that followed, the dear companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Tufail bin Amr, fought hard but eventually fell as a martyr on the battlefield. His son fought alongside and valiantly fought till his hand was cut off, and in the end he left his father and his hand buried in the soil of Yamama. Once during the time of Hazrat Umar Rizitala Anho, Hazrat Umar bin Tufail came to meet him. A table spread was laid as there were other people present too. Hazrat Umar did not sit for a meal but sat in a corner. So Hazrat Umar, the Caliph, asked him what was the reason and why was he not having the food. Then he realized that he may be conscious about his cut hand and asked that, is your hand stump stopping you from eating? Hazrat Tufail's son, Hazrat Umar, said yes. So Hazrat Umar said, by Allah, no one has more right and honor to eat from this table than you. It is only you that has this huge honor that before their death, a body part is already in Jannah. Dear kids, let's end today's lecture with a prayer that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants them, both son and father, the highest ranks in Jannah and grants us goodness to adopt and adapt their ways. Ameen. Hazrat Tufail Rizitala Anhu was a shaheed and was the father of a shaheed as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to adopt the goodness in others and develop the love of shahada in our hearts and mind. Ameen. Till next time, dear kids, look after yourselves, say your salah on time, and remember to be good. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.